With your station now up and running and connected to your Crosse View app, you'll likely have a few questions regarding how and where to find specific information. In this video, we will give you an overview of the items and actions you're likely to use most. After you have your station connected, your Crosse View app's main screen should look something like this, featuring a generic background image with some information displayed. The top information bar will help cue you in as to exactly what data you are viewing. It will list your previously created location name on top and user-defined device name underneath. It is this device's information that will be shown below. The darkened section will contain all of this device's data and include a simple glyph image to help you identify the device type. When first setting up your system, the first page will likely show your station's data, as shown here. For most of our stations, this will present you with your indoor temperature and humidity readings. Just to the right of the glyph will be a convenient message indicating the last time that device's data was updated to your app. And just to the right of that is actually the photo share button, which allows you to snap a picture with that device's data right on top and easily share it with family and friends. We will cover how to use this feature extensively in a later video. Underneath this first line will be your device's most important information, typically displayed as the largest text on screen. Depending on the model you own, this data may appear a little differently. To see more information about this device, simply press and scroll up to reveal more data below. The following section will contain the daily high and low cards, which again may show different types of information, depending on your device. If you continue scrolling, the graph card should be next. This section gives you easy access to your device's stored historical data. Simply press the blue expand icon in the upper right corner of this card to access this feature. More information and examples of how this graph card works will be shown in a later video as well. The next card listed will likely be for your data stream items, which can be accessed by pressing the blue stream icon in the upper right corner of the card. Most of our new connected weather stations come with this new data stream technology built right in, giving them the ability to receive and display additional forecast information from the NWS, as well as allow you to post personal messages right on their display. We will cover these specific data stream options in a later video, but for now, make sure you're on your station's device data page in order to see and adjust these elements. Data stream features are not available on sensor pages. Moving on, the final card listed under any device will be device information. It will inform you of when your app last received a data transmission from that device, give you a short description of what that device is, show you its device ID and model number, and let you know when its batteries are running low. Now that we've given you a basic rundown of the information you can find on a specific device page, let's show you how to navigate and find other device data. To do this, when on your main screen, simply swipe left to view your next device's information, indicated by the device name change on the top info bar, and glyph image change below. When initially setting up your system, you may only have a couple of devices listed under one location, meaning you'll only have two pages to view. But as you expand your system by adding new devices in new locations, you'll have multiple pages of data to view by swiping left and right. But as your system grows, finding specific device data can be a little bit of a hassle, having to swipe multiple times. That is why we've also implemented a quick view feature. By simply tapping the top information bar on an iOS device, or the quick view button in the top right of an Android, you will bring up all of the devices listed under that location, and their most important data. The swiping left and right function will work the same way in this quick view as well, except you'll move according to location instead of by individual device. Notice how the top location name changes. You can also use this quick view feature to jump directly to the specific device page you want. Simply just press the blue device title text at the top of its card. The Crosse View app is first organized by locations, and then by device order under those locations. For a visual understanding of this, let's look at an app with multiple locations and devices. Enter the main menu by selecting the main menu icon in the upper right corner for iPhone users, and upper left for those on an Android. The first items in this menu will be your bolded location names, with their connected devices listed underneath. These are searchable in this regard as well. Simply click on the device name you'd like to see. But this is the exact order in which your devices will be displayed when swiping left and right. We will teach you how to customize this order, as well as detail what the other items in this menu do in later videos. But for now, let's move on to your notification center. When you receive any kind of notification regarding your connected items, your iPhone Notification Center's cloud will turn red and show a number for the amount of notifications you've received since they were last checked. Android users, your cloud will actually stay white and present red numbers indicating your notifications. But on either system, simply press this icon to gain access to your notifications, which can be anything from temperature alerts to shared device messages. We will cover how all of these work in later videos. But basically, if your cloud is red, it is likely information you'll want to know. We hope this video helped you to understand the structure, basic functions, and some of the features the Crosse View app has to offer. Please continue through the rest of our training videos as we show you how to set up and use specific features, like setting alerts, sharing data with friends, adjusting your device order, and changing your location background images. Ultimately, we are here to help you, so please let us know if you have questions or ideas for support solutions you'd like to see us make in the comments section below. Thanks again for choosing Crosse Technology.